the city council was not put on a level playing field. There's only a couple of people that knew exactly what was happening.
Some Marco Island city council members claim they were kept in the dark about allegations against the former city manager before his arrest on battery charges. NBC2's Risa Morris has been digging into this investigative report today. It details how the council chair allegedly tried to use city business as a bargaining tool to get the victim to sign an agreement to keep quiet.
That investigative report says that Melissa Scott, the principal at Marco Island Academy here on the island, went to dinner with Lee Niblock to discuss city business when he started making advances towards her. Now that report also details a resolution or an agreement that Melissa Scott was asked to sign by the city attorney and some members of city council. And it also talks about how the city council chair, Jared Grifoni, was in touch with the board of directors president at Marco Island Academy, Melissa Scott's boss, telling them that it would be better for the school if that resolution was signed by the victim. Dr. Lee Niblock is facing allegations of inappropriately touching Melissa Scott and similar charges in Alachua County, where he worked in government as well. Jared Grifoni is the chair of the Marco Island City Council and says he's known about the allegations since February, when Scott reached out to the city.
The discretion and the privacy that the victim had requested was of utmost importance to really everybody involved.
Now Niblock is facing battery charges and he's currently out on bail. The investigative report shines light on the allegations against Niblock, but also on the involvement of city council members in the case. The report says Grifoni even contacted the victim on his own.
I had no additional contact with the victim beyond providing her the appropriate information for the city attorney's office.
The report says Grifoni also contacted the victim's employer at Marco Island Academy, telling her boss that the school would remain a legislative priority for the city if Scott signed a resolution.
I think that's probably a misinterpretation. I've been a strong supporter of the school from the beginning and continue to be to this day. I have a great relationship with the school.
Niblock's attorney says all of these details are new to him, but they intend to plead not guilty on the battery charge.
This is the very beginning of everything. So unfortunately, I don't have a lot of information right now.
Grifoni believes the city handled this in the best way.
Everything was handled, I think, appropriately, and that it was obviously a difficult situation for everybody involved.
Niblock was fired as the Marco Island city manager a couple months ago for other reasons while this investigation was ongoing. It's also important to note that the report also mentions that many of the city council members were left in the dark about the investigation and the resolution, while a few other city council members were kept apprised of the situation by Niblock and the city attorney. Reporting live on Marco Island, Risa Morris, NBC2.